to work out if these are water tanks.
This is the beef casserole with egg on it. And this is my crate of vegetables. Close it.
These are beautiful.
All the meat hanging around the outside.
As you can see on the map, the glacier Perito Moreno is just about in the centre of the map there, and it's about 50 kilometres out of El Calafate, where we're staying. It feeds into that giant lake at the back, which we're going to drive alongside in a few minutes. And the glacier itself is one of the biggest in the world. It's advancing. It's about 30 kilometres long and about 5 kilometres wide. The face of the glacier itself is about 100 metres high, so it's a fairly significant glacier. We're in a small group, about a dozen. We're going up to the glacier for the day.
Oh. you've got plenty of time. Well, this is the same face that we saw from the boat, excepting we were down there, right? This has been known to advance at up to 1 meter a day. So it's not surprising, you know, that you get regular carving. The weather's not 100%, but it's still a very beautiful place to be. This is the front end of the glacier. There's a waterway on both sides. This right-hand side is lower than the left-hand side, and the glacier calves on both sides, and this is the channel between the left side and the right side. Now when the glacier comes forward, it blocks this channel and builds up the water on the lake on the other side way up to 20 meters, and then the dam breaks and it all comes rushing through this little section here, and of course tumbles into this slightly lower lake on this side. Quite fascinating, really. This part here that I'm focusing on now is about 85 to 90 meters from the water to the top. Ooh, big bed. Sometimes within a glacier, you know, you actually get rivers of water through the ice. That's what it sounds like. Oh, what a fall up there.